Hello everyone and welcome back to my playlist of pathology which we are doing from Medium Robbins chapter number 20 continue कर रहे हैं which is about the endocrine system. Adrenal gland का discussion आज करेंगे and particularly we will talk about adrenal insufficiency. So as you know कि नाम से ही जाहिर है insufficiency का मतलब ये है कि the adrenal gland is not working okay. So if there is adrenocortical insufficiency, cortex की particularly or hypofunction may be caused by either primary adrenal disease, which is what we call the primary hypoadrenalism or decreased stimulation of the adrenal. So, you know how the endocrine axis basically works. If you have the kidneys here at the top of the kidney, you have the adrenal gland, and adrenal gland is stimulated by something. So, the glands are usually stimulated by something from the higher center. So, if that something is not working properly, this is what we call secondary hypoadrenalism. क्योंकि अगर ये say for example ACTH है और ACTH proper release नहीं और adrenocorticotropic hormone, so उसकी insufficiency है, उसका कोई problem है, तो adrenal तो ठीक है, adrenal is saying that I'm working fine, all that I need is a stimulus. The stimulus is not there. अच्छा अगर stimulus मौजूद है, if there is okay levels of ACTH and if there is problem with the adrenal itself. Cortex काम ही नहीं कर रहा, so इसे फिर हम कहते हैं primary insufficiency. So if the problem lies within the adrenal gland, primary insufficiency. If the problem does not lie within the adrenal gland and it actually lies in the higher centers, up above in the axis, then this is called secondary adrenal insufficiency. It's a simple concept. So again, adrenocortical insufficiency or hypofunction may be caused either by primary adrenal disease, which is what we call primary hypoadrenalism, or decreased stimulation of the adrenals by the ACTH deficiency, which is what we call secondary hypoadrenalism. Primary adrenocortical insufficiency can be acute or it can be chronic. If it's chronic, it is known as Addison disease. So Addison disease is the insufficiency of adrenal cortex, basically. Okay, now acute adrenal insufficiency, which is actually adrenal crisis, is most commonly seen in a lot of clinical settings outlined basically here. So if you look here, there is a Waterhouse-Friedreich syndrome, sudden withdrawal of long-term corticosteroid therapy, stress in the patient, underlying कोई अगर किसी को पहले से chronic adrenal insufficiency है and now there is any stressful situation. This stressful situation can be emotional, psychological stress, or for example surgery. So surgery is a stressful situation for the body. For example, infection is a stressful situation. So if somebody is suffering from chronic adrenal insufficiency and now there is infection or surgery, it will lead to exacerbation of adrenal insufficiency converted into adrenal crisis. Okay, individuals with chronic adrenocortical insufficiency may develop acute crisis after any stress. In patients maintained on exogenous steroids, rapid withdrawal of the steroids or failure to increase the steroid doses in response to acute stress. This is an important concept. See, we are talking about adrenal insufficiency. So if there is a person jiske andar adrenal gland kaam nahi kar raha hai, you are obviously giving steroids to them na, kyunki adrenal ka kaam hai steroid banana. Ab adrenal to kaam nahi kar raha hai, so you are giving them exogenous, this person is taking steroid. Now suppose the person is planned for a surgery, or the person is planned for anything which, well, actually not planned, infection mein likhne wala tha, so infection ki planning nahi hoti, but suppose the person gets infection. Aise bande mein jisme adrenal insufficiency diagnosed hai, and now you know that the person is planning for a surgery, or now you know if the person has acquired an infection, the immediate thing you need to think about is you need to increase the dose of the steroids. If you don't do this, there will be acute adrenal crisis, because now person obviously required more steroid. You know, in a normal person, aapki body mein emergency situations ko deal karne ke liye, you have steroids. Cortisol aapki body mein release hota. Kaun release karta? Adrenal cortex. Now it is not working and the person is taking exogenous steroid and there is a stressful situation. You need to increase the dose of the steroid. Okay. So massive adrenal hemorrhage may destroy enough of the adrenal cortex, cause acute adrenal, you know, this hemorrhage is an important cause. You need to remember that. This condition may occur in patients maintained on anticoagulant therapy, in post-operative patients, surgery ke baad, who develop DIC, during pregnancy, in patients suffering from overwhelming sepsis. So in tamam conditions mein there can be bleeding into the adrenal gland and failure of the gland. And this is what is known as Waterhouse-Friedreich syndrome. This catastrophic syndrome is classically associated with Neisseria meningitis septicemia. So remember, there is any widespread infection, septicemia, particularly because of Neisseria, yeah, because of DIC and other coagulation problems, there can be bleeding into the substance of the adrenal and it will fail. Okay. Waterhouse filtration syndrome can occur at any age, but it's somewhat more common in children. The basis for adrenal hemorrhage is uncertain, but may be attributable to direct bacterial seeding of small vessels in the adrenal and development of the DIC there, also because of vasculitis, which may be because of the endotoxins of the bacteria. So in all these conditions, there can be bleeding within the adrenal gland. So what I'm telling you, acute adrenocortical insufficiency can be, now go back to these causes, you will now understand this table. It can be because of Waterhouse filtration syndrome, which can be because of infection or DIC or septicemia, all these things. Sudden withdrawal of long-term corticosteroid therapy. Banda bahut arse se steroid le raha hai, ab aap achanak se usko block kar de. Yeah, stress in the patient. Two situations which I told you about stressful condition is surgery, which you have to remember, and also infection. So remember, whenever there are these two situations, they demand extra cortisol. And particularly if the person is already having chronic adrenal insufficiency, the person is on exogenous steroid, and these are the two conditions which happen in life now. You have to increase the dose of steroids, okay? Otherwise, the person will have acute adrenal crisis. Right. Now, this was all about acute stuff. The second thing which we have to talk about is the chronic, which is not an emergency situation, but it's a chronic problem. And this is what we call Addison disease. Addison disease or chronic adrenocortical insufficiency is an uncommon disorder resulting from progressive destruction of adrenal cortex. Aista aista adrenal cortex damage ho raha hai. More than 90% of the cases are attributable to one of the four disorders. Look at these disorders: autoimmune adrenalitis, TB, acquired immune deficiency AIDS, or metastatic cancer. So these are the conditions jisme agar adrenal gland में टीबी हो जाती है, ऑटोइम्यून इन्फेक्शन हो जाता, इन्फ्लेमेशन होती है, एंड एचआईवी और मेटास्टेटिक कैंसर, कहीं और से कैंसर ट्रेवल करके यहाँ आता. सो इन कंडीशंस में द एड्रिनल ग्लैंड इज डिस्ट्रॉयड. एड्रिनल का जो ऑटोइम्यून एड्रिनलाइटिस है अकाउंट फॉर अबाउट 60-70% ऑफ द केसेज ऑफ एडिसन डिजीज, द मोस्ट कॉमन कॉज. ओके, एज द नेम इम्प्लाइज, देर इज ऑटोइम्यून डिस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ द स्टीरॉइड प्रोड्यूसिंग सेल्स इन द एड्रिनल. And there are autoantibodies to several key steroidogenic enzymes which have actually been identified. Autoimmune adrenalitis may occur in association with several distinct autoimmune polyendocrine syndrome, APS jisko hum kehte hain, which is part of a bigger syndrome picture, jisme ek organ adrenal bhi hai jo affected hota hai. The best characterized of these are APS1, which are caused by mutations in AR genes, which are called autoimmune regulator gene on chromosome 21. It is characterized by mucocutaneous candidiasis and abnormalities in the skin and dental enamel and nails and also the adrenal gland. So that's a bigger picture, bigger syndrome, polyendocrine syndrome. Multiple organs are involved because there is a mutation in this gene and there are autoantibody production. Okay, the AIR protein is involved in the expression of tissue antigens in the thymus and elimination of T cell specific for these antigens. So the whole T recognition system is disturbed. Individual with this variant ABS1 develop autoantibodies against IL-17 and 22, which are the principal effectors secreted by T helper type 17 T cells, because these two TH17 drive cytokines are crucial for defense against fungal infection. These patients now develop a lot of fungal infections. So that's a little complicated paragraph, but watch my words a couple of times and you'll be fine. So I told you there are four major causes for chronic adrenal insufficiency. The first one of them is autoimmune problem, jisme aapko APS or AIR yaad rakhna hai. The second is infection, particularly tuberculosis. And TB is one of the major causes of destruction of adrenal glands. ठीक है, also some of the fungi. Tuberculous adrenalitis, which accounts for as many as 90% of the cases of Addison disease, has become less common because now we have very successful anti-tuberculous therapy. With the resurgence of tuberculosis, mainly because of HIV infection and immunodeficiency, this cause of adrenal deficiency must be borne in mind. So मैं यहाँ पे एक बात कहना ये चाहता हूँ कि you are a clinician, एंड यू नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड कि आप जिस लोकेलिटी में काम कर रहे हैं वहाँ पे एरिया स्पेसिफिक कंसर्न्स क्या है. सो फॉर एग्जांपल, ट्यूबरक्लोसिस इज स्टिल फाउंड इन अ लॉट ऑफ एशियन कंट्रीज. पाकिस्तान, इंडिया में कई पॉकेट्स उठा के आप देख लें, ट्यूबरक्लोसिस इज रिपोर्टेड. दिस डिजीज मे बी नॉन एग्जिस्टेंट इन सम ऑफ द वेस्टर्न वर्ल्ड, बट इन सम ऑफ द एशियन कंट्रीज इट इज स्टिल प्रेजेंट. सो यू नीड टू ऑलवेज बेयर दिस इन माइंड व्हेनेवर यू आर डीलिंग विद अ पर्सन हु हैज एड्रिनल इनसफिशिएंसी. ओके, now when present, tuberculous adrenalitis usually is associated with active infection on other sites as well. So TB does not only particularly affect only the adrenal gland, but it also affect other glands such as like lungs affected honge, GIT involved ho sakta hai. Among fungi, disseminated infection caused by histoplasma capsulatum and coccidioides immitis also may result in chronic. So abhi tak do baatein aapko samajh mein aayi कि दो मेजर इन्फेक्शन जो एड्रिनल को डिस्ट्रॉय कर रहे हैं, वन इज टीबी, अदर वन आर फंजाई. ओके, दैट्स एन इंपॉर्टेंट टेक होम मैसेज. एंड देन दिस इज ऑल्सो एन इंपॉर्टेंट कॉज, मेटास्टेटिक नियोप्लाज्म. कैंसर्स फ्रॉम अदर साइट्स कैन ऑल्सो कम टू द एड्रिनल ग्लैंड एंड डिस्ट्रॉय द एड्रिनल ग्लैंड. ओके, कार्सिनोमा ऑफ द लंग्स, ब्रेस्ट, दे आर द मेजर सोर्स ऑफ मेटास्टेसिस फॉर एड्रिनल्स. तो प्राइमरी एड्रिनल इंसफिशियंसी की कॉजेज. नाउ सेकेंडरी की अभी हम बात करेंगे, हम एक्यूट की बात कर रहे हैं इस वक्त. सो इफ आई हैव टू ड्रॉ अ चार्ट फॉर यू, इफ देयर इज हाइपो एड्रिनलिज्म, एड्रिनल्स आर नॉट वर्किंग फाइन, वी विल फर्स्ट डिवाइड देम इन टू प्राइमरी कॉजेज एंड सेकेंडरी कॉजेज. प्राइमरी कॉजेज कैन लीड टू एक्यूट क्राइसिस, दे कैन ऑल्सो बी ऑफ क्रॉनिक नेचर. इफ दे आर एक्यूट, they have all these causes. And if you talk about chronic, we talk about autoimmune disorder, infections, metastatic, and some other problems. Okay, now let us talk about some of the secondary causes. Now secondary causes may adrenal itself is not the primary area jo disturbed hai, but the problem is actually lying within the ACTH axis. So any disorder of the hypothalamus and pituitary that reduces the output of ACTH, और इसके कई सारे कॉजेज हो सकते हैं, सच एज मेटास्टेटिक कैंसर, इन्फेक्शन, इरेडिएशन, व्हाटएवर. इफ देयर इज एनी प्रॉब्लम विद हाइपोथैलेमस पिट्यूटरी एंड लो एसिटीएच, दिस इज व्हाट वी कॉल सेकेंडरी एड्रिनल इनसफिशिएंसी. एसिटीएच डेफिशिएंसी में अगर अलोन, बट इन मेनी केसेस देयर इज पेन हाइपोपिट्यूटरीज्म, सो देयर आर अदर प्रॉब्लम्स एज वेल. सो बेयर दिस इन माइंड फॉर डायग्नोसिस. नाउ In patients with primary disease, the destruction of the adrenal cortex prevents a response to exogenously administered ACTH in the form of increased plasma levels of cortisol. By contrast, the secondary adrenal cortical insufficiency is characterized by low serum ACTH and a prompt rise in plasma cortisol level. क्या बात हो रही है पता है? So imagine there are two patients, and that's an important paragraph, guys. बहुत important है primary और secondary में differentiate करने को. अब suppose इसमें मैं आपसे कह रहा हूँ कि there is a primary adrenal sufficiency, और इसमें मैं कह रहा हूँ there is a secondary problem. अब ये वाला जो बंदा है, इसमें adrenal gland सही काम कर रहा है या नहीं कर रहा, उसका एक indicator हो सकता है cortisol. Cortisol is something which is released from the adrenal, ना? तो अगर इस बंदे में cortisol के levels down है, और डाउन होंगे बिकॉज देर इज हाइपोएल्डोस्टेरॉनिज्म, देर इज हाइपो एड्रीनल फंक्शनिंग, देर इज हाइपो एवरीथिंग, दैट इज वॉट वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट इनसफिशियंसी, है ना. सो इफ द लेवल्स ऑफ कॉर्टिसोल आर डाउन एंड वी गिव दिस पर्सन ACTH, इसको ACTH का शॉर्ट देते हैं, तो मुझे ये बताओ क्या प्राइमरी एड्रीनल इनसफिशियंसी वाले पेशेंट में कॉर्टिसोल के लेवल दोबारा नॉर्मल होंगे नहीं होंगे? If you are saying no, you are right. Because कैसे होंगे? आप जितना भी ACTH दे दो यार, ACTH का तो मसला ही नहीं है, मसला adrenal gland का है. आप ACTH दोगे, वो और दोगे, और दोगे, और दोगे, जिसने cortisol बनाना है वही काम नहीं कर रहा, तो cortisol का level normal कैसे होगा? So इस case में even if you give a lot of ACTH, levels of cortisol will not go back to normal. अब इस case की बात सुने, यहाँ adrenal बिल्कुल ठीक है, ये इंतजार में है कि कहीं से ACTH आए. ACTH कम है ना, इट्स अ सेकेंडरी एड्रिनल इनसफिशियंसी. इस बंदे को अगर हम ACTH का शॉट देते हैं, तो बल्ले बल्ले ये तो खुश हो जाएगा, एड्रिनल ग्लैंड से फॉरन कॉर्टिसोल निकलेगा एंड द लेवल्स ऑफ कॉर्टिसोल विल गो अप. सो अ वेरी इजी वे टू डिफरेंशिएट बिटवीन अ पेशेंट ऑफ प्राइमरी एड्रिनल इनसफिशियंसी एंड सेकेंडरी एड्रिनल इनसफिशियंसी इज दैट गिव देम अ शॉट ऑफ कॉर्टिसोल ACTH एंड सी इफ द कॉर्टिसोल लेवल्स गो अप. इफ द कॉर्टिसोल लेवल्स गो अप, the adrenal glands are working fine. If the cortisol levels don't go up, that means adrenals are not working fine. And if adrenals are not working fine, it's primary adrenal insufficiency. And if adrenals are working fine and problem is with the ACTH, that is secondary. Okay, so I hope this is all clear. Clinically, how would the patient present is a very important heading to understand. In general, the clinical manifestation of adrenocortical insufficiency do not appear until at least 90% of the adrenal gland is compromised. Yani, agar thoda bahut adrenal damage hai, to pata bhi nahin chalega. 90% pe jaake symptoms aayenge. Aur jo initial manifestations hain, wo hain weakness, fatigability, and these are very very non-specific symptoms. Ye to har dusra banda keh raha hota hai, yaar main bahut thak gaya hoon, yaar mujhe fatigue ho raha hai. There can be GI disturbances, which are actually common. They include anorexia, bhook nahi lag rahi, vomiting, weight loss, diarrhea. In patients with primary adrenal disease, increased level of ACTH will be there obviously. Aur ACTH ki secretion ki physiology agar aapko yaad ho, so there are, you know, association with the melanocytes. So if there is increased ACTH, there will be hyperpigmentation of the skin as well as the mucosal surface, dark patches. The face, axilla, nipples, areola, perineum are particularly common sites of hyperpigmentation. So you suddenly see a patient jo thaka thaka rehta hai and there is hyperpigmentation, dark areas develop ho gaye in sari jagahon pe. So you would think about ke ACTH ka level bada hua hai. ACTH ka level basically isliye bada hai kyunki jo adrenal gland hai ab ye kaam nahi kar raha. There is a primary problem. Aur ACTH theek hai aapki body mein. So ACTH is coming over here and asking it to produce cortisol and all the required things, but this is not working. So ACTH goes crazy. It goes up and up and up, so there is more levels of ACTH and they will lead to hyperpigmentation. By contrast, hyperpigmentation is obviously not seen in the patient with secondary adrenocortical insufficiency. Why? Because in secondary there is decreased ACTH. ACTH hoga hi nahi, to hyperpigmentation kaise hogi? Decreased mineralocorticoid, yani aldosterone activity in the patient in primary adrenal insufficiency result in potassium retention, sodium loss, hyperkalemia, hyponatremia, volume depletion, hypotension. These are problems honge with the patient jiske andar adrenal gland kaam nahi kar raha, because agar adrenal kaam nahi kar raha to jo cheeze kam honi hai unme ek cheez hai aldosterone, aur aldosterone kam hone ki wajah se ye sare effects honge. So go watch my lectures on aldosterone physiology taki aapko pata ho aldosterone kya kya karta hai. And if there is no aldosterone, why would there be hyperkalemia, hypotension and all these things? Hypoglycemia occasionally may occur also, because adrenal kaam nahi kar raha na, to glucocorticoids ki bhi deficiency hai. But usually there are so many other pathways for glucose metabolism and maintenance ke hypoglycemia initial cheez nahi hoti. Theek hai? It is more common in infants and children than adults, hypoglycemia. Stresses and infections, trauma, surgical procedures in affected patients may precipitate adrenal crisis, and this is where sometimes the patient comes to the notice. कि usually अब सोचो ना, there is a patient with adrenal gland जिसका suppose अगर 50% adrenal gland damage है, तो उसको इतना routine life में पता नहीं चल रही चीजें, हल्का फुल्का थका वकावा रहता है इस तरह की चीजें, लेकिन अगर उसको infection हो गया और या कोई surgery उसने करवाई, so stressful situation में ये adrenal crisis immediately exacerbate करेंगे, so coma हो सकता है, severe hypotension, abdominal pain, collapse और ये सारी चीजें हो जाएंगी, right? So very important यार, adrenal insufficiency must understand concepts hai iske andar. Theek hai, to that's all about this video. Phir mazid baat karenge is chapter mein, agli video mein. Take care of yourself.